Hi, my name is Dan Brennan. I am a board-certified general pediatrician at the Sansum Clinic for the past 12 years.
My name is Ali Javanbacht. I'm a board-certified family physician. I work for our Sansum Clinic at the Carpinteria branch. I've been practicing there for the past 11 years, doing preventative care for children, teens, adults, and also acute care and management of chronic diseases.
I'd like to talk today about the Tdap vaccine. All seventh graders that will be starting in junior high this year will need to show proof that they received the Tdap vaccine from their pediatrician's office. The Tdap vaccine is a booster immunization for older children, adolescents, and adults that provides protection against three very important bacteria: tetanus, diphtheria, and pertussis.
Vaccines in general are very, very safe. The Tdap in particular has been around for years. And it's been administered to millions of children, and most importantly, protects them from getting whooping cough, and it also serves as a tetanus booster, which is a good idea for everyone to have every 10 years.
Tetanus is a bacteria that can enter the body through a dirty cut or wound. Diphtheria is a bacteria that fortunately we don't see a whole lot of these days due to our excellent vaccination programs, but we do still provide protection within these vaccines. Pertussis, also known as whooping cough, is at a 60-year high in the state of California. This is a very contagious bacteria that can cause months and months of coughing fits and spasms. In our tiniest patients, it's been known to cause a stoppage of breathing, seizures, and even some children have died.
The point I try to get across with the whooping cough booster is that if a healthy person, a healthy adult, a healthy teen gets whooping cough, they'll have this nagging cough for about 6 weeks, 8 weeks. Chances are they'll probably get better. The problem is that the at-risk population, newborns younger than 2 months, frail elderly, these are populations that are high risk of complications, even death, if they get whooping cough. The problem with whooping cough is it's kind of a tricky disease. The first week that someone has it, it's indistinguishable from a regular cold. And yet they're passing around the whooping cough. The number one cause of infection in these at-risk groups is a healthy adult caregiver who thinks they just have a cold, but they're going around spreading whooping cough. So part of the idea is that if we can vaccinate more of the healthy population, that'll help to protect these at-risk groups as well, so they don't get whooping cough and they don't get the complications from it.
Parents often ask if their child still needs to receive the Tdap vaccine if their child has had either tetanus or pertussis or diphtheria in the past. And the answer is yes, because previous infection with these bacteria does not provide long-lasting immunity.
So to get the Tdap vaccine and get it updated, that's usually done at the well visit. So parents can contact the primary care provider of the child and set up a well visit appointment. The sooner that's done, the better. There tends to be a big rush near the end of the summer season when everyone's trying to get them in before the school year. So earlier is better, so there's enough time to get in, review the vaccine record, get them updated as needed, so they'll be protected in the upcoming school year.
The Tdap vaccine is indicated for anybody that's going to be around small children, especially those new infants. It is a great vaccine for pregnant women, expecting fathers, grandparents, and other caregivers.
So if you'd like to set up a well visit for your child to get them updated on their vaccines, you can call 1-800-4-SANSUM to set up that appointment.